The system works in a far more intelligent way. A combination of tripwires, the setting of object direction with tracking, and perspective compensation ensures false alarms do not occur. In this scene, a tripwire is placed along an area where something should not cross. In this case, next to a fence. Multiple tripwires can be placed in one scene if required. The addition of arrows ensures only an object traveling in the direction of the arrows will trigger an alarm. The distance the object must travel before triggering the alarm can also be easily set. When monitoring a fence, although a person's height does not change, as they move further away from the camera, the smaller they appear. A simple walk test allows the system to compensate for this perspective and learns what, in this case, 1.6 meters looks like at various different distances from the camera. This ensures that small objects in the distance do not trigger false alarms. This scene shows perspective compensation in practice in the application of a physical or virtual barrier in an uncrowded environment where objects try to cross the barrier should be detected. The person is tracked first in green with a box to alert the operator of the object, and then as the tripwire is crossed next to the fence, turns red as the system is now in alarm. The same scene now shows the attempt to climb the fence at a much further distance, ensuring clear tracking and then alarming of the object. Of course, normally the tripwire would not be visible to the operator. It is shown here for demonstration only. Nuisance alarms are mainly caused by nature, in this case, birds. The bird is sitting on the fence and flies across the area being monitored. The size of the bird is large enough for it to be tracked. However, it is too small to trigger an alarm. Therefore, no false alarm is caused. A whole flock of birds now fly in the background, and again, one or two are tracked because of their size. But they are also disregarded as not a true alarm. A cyclist is riding on the public side of the fence, and although seen and tracked through the fence with the color green, no false alarm is caused. Natural elements normally cause false alarms. However, the EDS algorithm is very robust against such environmental factors. Two trip wires have been set, and as the two people walking split, the system then independently tracks them through the falling snow until alarms are triggered. In conjunction with standard tripwires are dynamic tripwires. Here an object can appear anywhere in the detection scene, and the values of the dynamic tripwire automatically apply to where the object appears. In this case, the object can move in directions allowed, as shown by the arrows, and only for the length set. In this case, 1 meter. This is ideal when viewing areas such as prison walls or grounds where it is likely that prisoners could break out of a wall or come up through the ground. At this prison, extensive tests were carried out using the dynamic tripwire functionality, as the prisoners have opening windows covered with bars. The system was configured to allow waving of objects up to 1 meter. But should the object move further than 1 meter, an alarm should trigger, as this could be an